I'm going to show you how to set up Sidekick for Heroku. I've gone ahead and added Sidekick to my gem file already. I've created a YAML file which contains all the queues which Rails normally quite likes to see. And I've created an initializer which has a few of the common configurations which we'll go through in a minute. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to make the worker appear when we deploy. So I'm going to go to the proc file. And I'm going to add a line in here called worker, and this is going to run bundle exec sidekick, and that's just going to run sidekick kind of just as we do locally. So let's commit that. Cool. Awesome. Heroku's picked up that we just pushed that up, and we can see that in here. And it's now currently doing the build, and it's releasing it. So that's pretty good. So hopefully it should appear in just a moment. There it is. Looks like it's turned off. Let's turn it on. Fantastic. We're going to have a look at the logs now just to see how this is going. Looks like it ran into an error. Let's have a look at our exception monitor and see what it tells us. Okay, looks like we've got a error connecting to Redis. Well, that's cool. We haven't actually created Redis as an add-on yet. Let's add that in. Cool, I'm adding Heroku Redis. It's got a pretty generous free tier. And it will be perfect for us. Okay, that looks to have been provisioned. Let's have a look at the logs now. Oh, look, our Sidekick worker is booted. This is nice, but I think you'd want to see something a bit more visual. In the Sidekick initializer, I've required the Sidekick web UI, and this is like a nice dashboard you get with Sidekick, and it just kind of tells you what's going on. In the roots, I've also mounted it here, so if we just go to /sidekick, it will appear. The only thing we need to do now is configure a username and password. This just kind of protects it from like prying eyes in production, so we could use it there as well. So I'm going to go to settings. I'm going to quickly configure a username and password for Sidekick. So let's call this Sidekick. And I'm going to set a password called Sidekick. Okay. Let's watch this quickly go out. And it does this deploy. Awesome. Let's have a look at this Sidekick UI panel in a browser. So I'm going to open it in a new window. I'm going to go to /sidekick. And we set the username and password as both Sidekick. And this is the overview. And when jobs come in, they'll just appear here. That is the end of this video. I'm hoping you found that useful and enjoyable. I am MikeRogers0 on Twitter. If you have any questions, feel free to send me a message or drop a little comment underneath this video. Thank you for watching, and I will catch you next time.